waking up in the morning to mom singing and playing the piano, and her cleaning the house with like early 90s Twilight Paris on. She was just always worshiping. She was always worshiping at home, and we would just, I remember walking into random rooms in the house and just seeing her tears streaming down her face, just worshiping. And I know a lot of you only know her from church, so you might feel you've seen her worshiping and you only know the church side of Gail, but you know her. That was her in the truest sense. Like, I was talking to Dad, and I just feel like all of us have an eternal identity that maybe we don't know yet, and I think Mom discovered hers early on in life, that she was a worshiper. She stepped into it early, and she did it here for us to see, and now she's really doing it. But just so you know, that wasn't just here. Like, that was her everywhere.
The one I want to reiterate, but first the new side of Mom. She was a gift giver. She loved giving presents. And if you ever got a present from my mom, it was just what you needed or just what you wanted. She loved taking us shopping, or just a lot of times after school. This was before we homeschooled. Sarah and I were in elementary school in Florida. We'd walk in and there'd be presents on the bed. She'd gone shopping and just gotten us things. It wasn't her birthday. We thought it was the best thing ever. She passed that on, I think, to all of us. We love giving presents. We love throwing parties and giving presents. We didn't realize that St. Patrick's Day wasn't a major holiday until I think we were in high school, because we had a St. Patrick's Day party or dinner. Every minor holiday was a big deal at our house, and that's just her joyful party side. And then I just wanted to reiterate what Dad and also Megan and Sarah said, that Mom heard the voice of the Lord. She heard it more than anyone that I've ever met. And I just feel, and I know Sarah said it too, but so blessed to have that legacy, because that's what's making me not feel bereft right now, because I still hear from God. I still hear from Him. And she gave me that. So I just wanted to end the daughter's time of just reading something that Mom wrote from the Lord. I snoop. This was beside her chair. And I was actually really hungry to hear from God during this one point in her sickness back in right around New Year's. And I wasn't hearing from the Lord. And I needed something. And I saw that she had written something, and I read it shamelessly. because it was from Jesus to Mom. And so I just wanted to end with her words. Jesus' words through Mom. He said, "Gail, I love you. I will never forsake you. Till the end of the age and beyond, my love for you is infinite. As you struggle in this life, I am with you. As you strive to please me in all things, I aid you. But never lose sight of eternity. It stretches out before you like a vast sea, shining and welcoming. You cannot imagine all that I have in store for you in the next life. Rest in me as you contemplate this truth. Rest in me. Eternity is yours, secured by my blood, by my love for you as evidenced throughout your life." "Do not fear death, neither welcome it prematurely. There is a time appointed for you to die, and then you will come to live with me forever. Trust me that I will bring you through in victory, to the end, and then on into the beginning. This should give you great peace in your heart, great joy that can't be taken away. This pain is temporary. I will take it from you. All pain is temporary and will fly away at the end, along with all tears and sorrow. This struggle is not for naught. It will gain you crowns in heaven for your persistent fight of faith. But there is also an end, and you are approaching it. Rest in me every day and have peace. Trust me to deliver you. Trust me to bring you safely home. Trust me and relax into my arms. I love you more than you can ever know, Jesus.